Good morning, students of class 10. In the period of geography, that climate of India is continue. In the last class, we have seen the explanation of local winds. Those were Lu, Kal Baisakhi, Bardoli Chira, Mango Showers, and so on. Today, we will see the southwest monsoon winds. Our next topic of the climate of India southwest monsoon winds. We shall try to understand this topic through this diagram. Let us draw the map of India. And the east of Indian subcontinent, the Bay of Bengal, in the west, the Arabian Sea, somewhere you will find the spelling of Arabian, A-R-B-E-A-N. A-R-B-I-A-N is also correct, A-R-B-E-A-N is also correct. And here, in extreme south, Indian Ocean, southwest monsoon winds. In this, we discuss about the period of June to September. June to September. Before that, we had hot and dry season, that was between March to May. In this period, there is a temperature difference between the Indian subcontinent and the water bodies. In Indian subcontinent, there was high temperature, and in water bodies, there was low temperature. Low temperature, LT, low temperature. And this high temperature is found mostly in northwestern India. And this low temperature is found in the water bodies, that is in the Bay of Bengal and the Arabian Sea. So this temperature difference leads pressure difference. Where there is a high temperature, there will be low air pressure, and where is a low temperature, there will be high air pressure. So in Indian subcontinent, there will be low air pressure, and in water bodies, there will be high air pressure. So you are seeing this temperature difference leads the air pressure difference between Indian subcontinent and the water bodies during June to September. Now what happens? rule says the winds will blow from the high pressure to the low pressure. So these winds start blowing from south towards west. From all the water bodies, these winds blow from south to west. Okay, so since these winds are coming from the water bodies, these winds remain laden with the moisture. As these winds get the support of the height of the mountains being lighter, these winds rise up and the process of condensation starts. Under the process of condensation, these winds, those are laden with the moisture, are changed into water droplets. As per the process of condensation, water droplets are heavier, and being heavier, these water droplets start falling on the ground as the rainfall. So in June to September, this season is monsoon season. We say monsoon season because this season is responsible for the rainfall. Or in other words also we say that hot and wet season. Hot and wet season. And this happens due to temperature difference. So, and temperature difference leads the pressure difference. So we write few features of these monsoon winds. We write some features of this period June to September between Indian subcontinent and water bodies. There is a temperature difference between Indian subcontinent and water bodies. So we write high temperature in the Indian subcontinent and high temperature leads the low air pressure. So we write together low air pressure in the Indian subcontinent . Third is, now we compare with the water bodies. At the same time, in water bodies, there will be low temperature in water bodies. These water bodies are the Bay of Bengal and the Arabian Sea. And why this temperature difference is found in the same season? Because this is the nature of the land, that it is heated quickly, it is heated in short time. The rate of heating is very fast of the land, but rate of heating of the water is very slow. Therefore, the water of ocean and seas take time to be heated up, while the land is heated in short. Therefore, due to this reason, there is a temperature difference between Indian subcontinent and the water bodies. This temperature difference will lead the air pressure difference. Where will be high temperature, there will be low air pressure. And where there will be low temperature, air pressure will be high. So this fourth feature we write here, low temperature, high air pressure. High air pressure. in water bodies. Water bodies. On the basis of these features, the winds start blowing from the water bodies to the Indian subcontinent from both the sides, and this is called monsoon winds because this remain laden with the moisture, and after the process of condensation, these winds rain in Indian subcontinent. Now, the name of these monsoon winds, name of the monsoon winds, I write here, name of the monsoon winds those blow during this month June to September is called southwest monsoon wind. Why is it called southwest monsoon wind? On the basis of direction, it is coming from south and going towards west. It is coming from south and going towards west, west of India, west region of India. Therefore, the name of this monsoon winds is given the southwest monsoon winds. The south west monsoon winds. The southwest monsoon winds. This name is given on the basis of its direction. Other names are also given to this southwest monsoon wind on the basis of its nature. Since it is going ahead, it is moving forward, so this is also known as the advance monsoon wind. The advance monsoon winds. And one more name is given, that is first became the southwest monsoon wind, second is the advanced monsoon wind, and third is due to its season, this is the summer season, so this is called the summer monsoon wind. The summer monsoon winds. So these monsoon winds have three names. First is the southwest monsoon wind, second is the advanced monsoon wind, third is the summer monsoon winds. Now we see the feature of these monsoon winds. The first feature, that these monsoon winds rain almost throughout the country except the few places. And during this period, during the rainfall, there is heavy rainfall with thunderstorm, and sudden heavy rainfall, mind it, the sudden heavy rainfall with thunderstorm is called bursting of monsoon winds. The bursting, we write the bursting. The bursting of monsoon winds. What is the feature of this? The sudden heavy rainfall. Sudden heavy rainfall with thunderstorm. It can create the situation of flood. The bursting of monsoon wind that is found or that occurs during June to September of during southwest monsoon winds. What is the feature? Sudden heavy rainfall with thunderstorm. that is named as bursting of monsoon winds. It can cause a flood. And one more thing, when there is no rainfall at least 2 or 3 weeks, that situation is called the break of monsoon winds. The break of monsoon winds. The feature of this during monsoon season, no rainfall at least for 2 or 3 weeks. During the month of June to September. If there is no rainfall, that is the monsoon season, it should rain. But if there is no rainfall, at least for 2 or 3 weeks, then that situation is called the break of monsoon winds. It can cause drought. This bursting of monsoon winds can cause flood. That is the sudden heavy rainfall with thunderstorm. That can cause flood. But break of monsoon winds, in which there is no rainfall at least 2 or 3 weeks, that can cause drought. And this situation is break of monsoon wind. One more thing that I want to explain in the same topic. This Kerala is the first state that experiences the incoming of monsoon winds. Means the monsoon winds enter at first in Kerala, and this Kerala experiences the withdrawal of monsoon winds. Means the monsoon winds departed at last from Kerala. So Kerala is the first state by which arrival of monsoon winds and departure of monsoon winds both are experienced.